Riot Grrrl to me is about us girls taking over the means of production together to create and recreate actions and images which actively challenge the status quo in our lives, to utilize the means of production accessible to us in a manner which challenges dominant standards of professionalism. One of the common misconceptions of Riot Grrrl is that it only consisted of a small group of white, middle-class, college-educated, cisgendered females, girls. And both Ceci and my experiences in the Bay Area and LA were really diverse.
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't really my experience as being fully, certainly not like a straight girl scene. For me, it was one of the first ways that I accessed any kind of queer culture.
Most of the time, life outside of my mind and my house is totally crazy. It's like playing Hot Lava, and I think, fuck, are we really still playing Hot Lava? Still? Do I really have to jump from the couch to the bookshelf to the piano bench and back without touching the carpet?
Astria and I try to work together to select scenes that really represent all the different topics that are addressed. For example, we have zines that are written by sex workers talking about sex work. We have fanzines that are talking about being of color in the punk scene. We have fanzines that talk about mental illness, fat activism. So it was important for us to really, you see kind of like how the politics of Riot Grrrl really kind of touched on a range of different social issues. Mm-hmm.
The title of the zine is derived from a schoolyard game by the same name. The game was to say Chinese, Japanese, Indian chief, and to look like each of these groups. When you said Chinese, you'd use your hands to stretch your eyes out and upwards. When you said Japanese, you'd stretch your eyes out and downward. And when you said Indian chief, you'd put your hand behind your head and spread out your fingers to resemble a headdress. But the real game was to slowly kill all people of color by fostering white superiority and internalized racism into young children in a playful, acceptable form. This zine is about telling the truth from many different perspectives. Chinese, Japanese, Indian chief, we're not playing that game anymore.
Throughout the 90s, I published something called Outpunk, which was a fanzine as well as a record label devoted to LGBT music, queer punk, both here in San Francisco in the United States and abroad. Zines facilitated a type of expression that I didn't know any existed anywhere else.
Some Riot Grrrl zines that I can remember that really changed things for me. Well, the biggest one for me was I'm So Fucking Beautiful by Nomi Lam, who's actually a San Francisco person. But her work, it just changed things for me to see this queer feminist approach around bodies and representation and access that, and also just contributing to feminism in a way that, as someone in my 20s, it seemed like something that was done by people who are older than me. So Riot Grrrl was really influential in giving me permission to contribute and make art as opposed to just consuming it.
And she wonders if they comprehend the importance of what she is doing. Not just her, but everyone who is out there in some dark corner, desperately trying to find their voice, aching to be heard by others. Is anyone out there? Because sometimes it seems that no one's listening. They're nodding their heads and acting like they get it, but nothing changes.
It's interesting to think about Riot Grrrl as coming out of, it doesn't come from nowhere, right? And you don't want to only credit it as coming out of, as a resistance to a white boy punk scene. That it actually has roots in feminism and queer activism that are not just a response to the quote-unquote mainstream of punk rock, you know?
I think that all things are related, race, class, gender, able-bodiedness, age, and size. It's important to notice who the worker is behind the apron, just as it is important to notice who the person is behind the color of their skin.
Riot Grrrl is love, listening, changing, undefinable. A time to be intimate without fear of anyone laughing at me. Riot Grrrl meetings are a place for me to deal with my own homophobia, racism, self-esteem, communication, arrogance, craziness, talking, listening, feeling, changing, acting.